Do your tenants sometimes ask you to apply the security deposit to the last month's rent? Well, then you should watch this video, Applying Security Deposits to Last Month's Rent. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. It's very simple to apply a tenant's security deposit to the last month's rent. Just swap over the security deposit balance to the normal rent payout balance. Then transfer the funds from the tenant's trust account to the operating account for paying the landlord later. And then the last step is paying the landlord their normal monthly rent payout the way you normally do. That's it, four simple steps. So what will happen when we actually change over or swap over the tenant's deposit over to the rent payable for the landlord? Well, first, the tenant security deposit liability account will go down because we no longer owe the tenant specifically for a security deposit. But what will increase is the balance of the rent that we will pay out to landlords, because now that is part of the future rent payout. So that's it, four simple steps, but here's the problem. Step number two can be a little tricky. Step number two doesn't take 1 second with one entry, it takes 2 seconds with two entries. Well, why is that? Why is step number two special? So what exactly needs to happen? Well, the tenant security deposit was owed to the tenant, so we can't have that in our records anymore. And if it becomes part of the rent payable to landlords, now it's owed to the landlord. So because this is what needs to happen in your records, it would be great if we could swap over from tenant security deposit to landlord payout balances in one simple entry. But QuickBooks won't let us do it in one simple entry. It's the same problem that we spoke about before regarding QuickBooks Desktop and receivable type of accounts. Only one accounts receivable account per journal entry is the error message that you will get. For example, let's imagine on March 31, Betty moves out and says, please apply my security deposit to the last month's rent, March. Now, it would be great if we could just record this in one simple entry. It would be great if QuickBooks let us do this. Make a debit to the security deposit payable account to decrease what you owe the tenant, and make a credit to the rent payable account to increase what you owe to the landlord as rent payout. But unfortunately, QuickBooks will not let us do that. If you try to do it this way, you will get this error message. And we learned about this error message before. If only QuickBooks would let us use more than one accounts receivable account in a transaction, we would be finished, and this would be the easiest part of the course. But it will not. So how do we work around this? Well, instead of recording it in one step with 1 second, we record it in 2 steps and take 2 seconds. First, we have to move the tenant's security deposit to a place that QuickBooks will allow us to post it. Then once it's there, we then move the security deposit to where it belongs in the rent payable to landlord clients, just like all the other normal rent payouts. So what is this mysterious intermediate place that will hold the tenant security deposit for a brief second? We already know what that is. It's the already paid clearing account. That's what we use to be able to work around issues that QuickBooks makes difficult for us. So, step one will look like this. Debit the tenant security deposit liability payable account to make it zero, or at least remove that particular tenant's balance, and make a quick credit to the already paid clearing account. What that will do, it will move the tenant security deposit to the clearing account for a brief second. Then we do the second step. Debit the already paid account to make it zero because we're done using it, and credit the account where the money belongs, rent payable to landlord client. And that will increase the rent payable for the next monthly rent payout. And what this journal entry will do is move the money from the clearing account to where it belongs, the rent payable to landlord clients. Now, what will be the result in the trial balance when we move $1,000 of one particular tenant security deposit from the security deposit to the normal rent payout? Well, if we move a security deposit away, that means that $1,000 is going to decrease this balance. The tenant security deposit decreases by $1,000 because we moved away from it $1,000 worth of one of the tenant security deposit. But where did it go when we finish step two? When we finish step two, it went to the rent payable to the client for the normal monthly payout, and it increased the amount we're going to pay that landlord client for that tenant security deposit. So when we finish both steps, rent payable to landlord client should be $1,650, and tenant security deposit should equal $2,000. Let's take a look at how to record step one. Move it to the clearing account. We click Company, Make Journal Entry. We put the date as March 31st. And we're going to make a debit to the tenant security deposit account for $1,000 because it's a liability that we are decreasing because we no longer have that security deposit. And we're temporarily moving it into the already paid account. 1 second, save and close. We also have to include, we have to include the name. We have to include the customer. In this case, it's Betty Boop under Alan Arby, and she must be put on both lines of the journal entry. Now, when we click Save and New, we can now move on to step two, move the deposit to the rent payable account. Very simple. We now go to the landlord, rent payable to landlord client, and we credit that. Usually the debit account goes first. That's technically official form, but doesn't really matter in the computer. So we debit the already paid account, and we credit the rent payable to landlord client. And in both cases, you have to put the tenant's name so QuickBooks knows which specific tenant security deposit to remove. Now when we click Save and Close after step two and we take a look, you can see that the numbers are exactly as what we expected. The tenant security deposit payable has decreased to $2,000, but the rent payable to landlord client increased to $1,650. Now, the most important reports are the detailed reports. When I look at the tenant security deposit report, I see that we pay back nothing to Betty because on March 1, she gave us a security deposit, and on March 31, we made this general journal entry to bring her security deposit down to zero. Why is it zero? Because if you look in the landlord payout balances report, you can now see that if you isolate March, which is what you'll have to do when you work with this report, you have to isolate it by month to really understand what's going on. Hit refresh, and you can see that Alan, the landlord, is now going to get this $1,000 that came from the general journal entry when you swapped over the rent that security deposit that was owed, switching it over to the rent balance in this report. So we now know how much to pay Alan at the end of March. Now there's one more part to this little story, the last part. We must transfer the tenant's deposit from the tenant's cash deposit bank account to the operating bank account so that you can give them their normal monthly payout for the tenant's rent, less expenses and service fee, like we did before. It's not recommended that you pay the landlord directly from the trust account because the money is now simply part of the normal monthly payout. So on March 31, we transferred $1,000 from the trust bank account to the operating account. And what will happen after step two? Well, cash in bank will increase because we just put money in the operating account, and tenant's cash deposit trust account, the physical bank account that holds tenant's deposits, will now decrease because it is no longer in the account. It's in the operating account because now it's part of the normal monthly rent payout. And what will happen in the trial balance when we move the money from one bank account to the other? Well, the tenant's cash deposit bank account will decrease by the $1,000 we transfer out, and the Chase bank account will increase by the $1,000 that we just put in. And these will be the results after we make that very simple transfer on March 31. We click Banking, Transfer Funds. And this is the easiest transaction in QuickBooks. The money is coming from the tenant's cash deposit. The money is going to the Chase Bank operating account, and the amount is $1,000. You can put a nice memo explaining applied Betty or whatever you would like to write, save and close. Now the results are exactly as what we expected. Cash in bank increased to $4,800. Tenant's cash deposit decreased to $3,000. And now this $3,000 equals the total. Well, it equals what you have. And then this will just get paid out with the normal monthly rent.